What's going on, everyone? It's Justin here, and today I've got a video showing you another tech product from Louis Vuitton. So this right here is the Tambour Horizon watch, and it comes in at a price in Canada at $3,651. We're gonna check out the packaging, the hardware, the design, as well as some of the features that it has as a smartwatch itself in terms of utilities. I am also gonna compare it to a watch that I believe is a very good value, and that is the TicWatch Pro that comes in at under $200 and also has a lot of smart features. I'm gonna be giving away my TicWatch Pro in this video though, so just make sure you subscribe to the channel, drop a like on this video, and also leave a comment down below. And I would also really appreciate it if you guys wanna follow me on Instagram and Twitter, and I'll be announcing a winner in the comment section when this video hits 3,000 likes. If you guys remember, about a month ago, I did do a video of the Louis Vuitton wireless earbuds, which in Canada were almost $1,500, and it was kind of a cool experience to check out what LV did in their collab when it came to design, but also compare it to something that is more reasonably priced like the Apple AirPods. Louis Vuitton actually initially released the Tambour Horizon watch in 2017, and I actually wanted to check it out back then but didn't end up getting around to it. But earlier this year, they actually announced a new model, which is the one right here for 2019, and it is the one with the updated specs, including a Snapdragon Wear 3100 processor, as well as an improved AMOLED display, a bit of a different design, and I just wanted to see what it was all about for the first time. I've never actually seen it in person. So it's kind of cool to see like companies like Louis Vuitton are trying out some tech products. It just makes it very interesting from the typical stuff we tend to review. So looking at the packaging itself, it is the very typical Louis Vuitton packaging in the orange, which is a nice paper texture, as well as the ribbon and everything. And you can also get it with a customizable strap in many different designs and materials. This case right here came with the packaging, and when I opened it up, it was actually empty. So I don't know if there was a mistake with my order, whether or not this even came with a strap, but we're probably gonna find out when I open up this box. There's just, I guess, some information, but we're going to set that aside and figure out how to. So just sliding that out, you have a box, which is the same look as the sleeve, paperwork, and just some general information, which we're gonna go ahead and set up and see how it is to use. But on this side, you have, let's see. Oh, it actually opens out like this. So let's take a look at this one first. So kind of slides out, and here you have the charger, which is micro USB, so it would have been nice to have seen USB Type-C like we saw in the earbuds, but has like a little LV shell to the end of it. And aside from that, you also have, I believe, what is the connector for the watch charging piece itself. There's another pouch, so I guess at this price point, you do expect a pouch for everything and just the nice packaging. And that is just the USB wall plug. So the wall plug itself is only 1 amp, so I imagine this watch doesn't actually charge that fast, but the battery is only 300 milliamp hours, so it doesn't exactly have to. So now onto the watch itself in this kind of navy blue leather case, and it has the imprint right here, and it is nice and boxy. The design is there, and it does look like we do have the strap, and I was getting a little bit worried because one of the boxes came completely empty. So the watch itself is a 42 millimeter case, which is a little bit bigger, I think, for my wrist, but it is the only size it comes in. And let's just slide this out here, and there you have the watch itself. It is in a polished stainless steel. It says Louis Vuitton along the trim. You also have the dial to control different things, and you also have a 24-hour kind of always on display or ring that goes around the edge, which is new for this year. And the strap itself is a standard Demure that you kind of see across the entire line of LV products when it comes to their wallets, card holders, and bags. So there's that. I'm gonna go ahead and take out the plastic in a second, but let's just see what is in kind of this last compartment here. You've got the instruction manual and just a whole bunch of paperwork, but overall the packaging experience at this price point is kind of what you expect when it comes to accessories and just the presentation of it. So after I went ahead and set up the watch, I have to say that I actually like the way it feels and looks a little bit more than I initially expected. But let's just talk about some of the hardware, the design, and the features of why this watch costs so much, and if you do decide to buy it, what it can do. So this watch ranges anywhere from under $3,000 all the way to, I believe in Canada, over $6,000 for the ceramic model. This one right here is kind of like the mid-end with stainless steel and one strap, and you do have the option between many different straps, but I found that a lot of them were out of stock. The watch itself is 42 millimeters in size, and if you're someone who's relatively small like myself and doesn't have the widest wrist, then 42 might be a little bit large, but it is the only size that is kind of offered in. The watch itself is 12.6 millimeters thick, which isn't the thinnest thing out there, but I was surprised by how light it actually felt despite its size. When I first saw this thing online, I thought it was gonna be very, very heavy on the wrist. This one right here has polished steel, and it also has sapphire glass on the case back as well as on the front screen. So most devices use a sort of glass. It is much more resistant to cracks and scratches, and it is what is found on the lenses of a lot of smartphone cameras. So I think with any fashion item, it's really easy to forget the tech side of things, but this actually has some of the latest and greatest specs for a smartwatch. For starters, the display on the front is a 1.2 inch display with a resolution of 390 by 390, but it is now an AMOLED screen. This pretty much gives you a PPI of 327, and I think one of the biggest complaints of the previous generation is that the display just wasn't that good. You've also got 1 gig of RAM paired with 8 gigs of internal storage, and it is powered by the newest Snapdragon Wear 3100 processor, which has many different improvements, including power as well as battery life. But I think the biggest efficiency part is when paired with the coprocessor, which is just 7 nanometers, it consumes up to 20 times less power. So for any tasks that don't need the main processor, it allows you to have much more usage time if you're just using it as a standard watch or doing low impact tasks. The battery life on the Tambor Horizon should last you a full day, which isn't anything impressive, but definitely an improvement, and up to 5 days if you're just using it as a watch without any of the major smart features. The buckle on this model is also made out of stainless steel, and the straps are very easily interchangeable if you decide to get a spare one or different colors, and all you have to do is press the notch on the back and clip it off, and within seconds you're good to go. And this model does also have built-in NFC and is water resistant up to 30 meters, which is much more than a lot of the other smartwatches that I've seen. It of course does have many typical other smartwatch features, including a vibration motor, gyroscope, ambient light sensor, and a microphone. But because of its size, I would have liked to have seen a better battery life, perhaps 2 full days, because the battery in terms of numbers is only 300 milliamp hours inside of the watch. So when it comes to software and the user experience, this is a Wear OS watch. So characteristically, if you're using an Android device, you're able to take advantage of many more features and applications when compared to iOS, but that doesn't mean you can't use it with an iOS device like I have in my case. On the Android side of things though, you can try many different apps that are available on the Android Wear App Store, but LV has also tried to take that experience even further with their own LV connected app. There is also an exclusive app called LV City Guide, and what this does is kind of give you guides to some of the major cities around the world in a 24-hour basis in terms of activities to do, things to go, places to eat, and stuff like that. Something that you probably won't use that much, but it's still kind of cool to play around with and just look at for the first time. In terms of build quality, I think they've done a good job on the dial on the side, and by pressing it, it brings up all of your applications and also allows you to scroll between the different menus. It's very tactile and responsive as expected. So at the end of the day, this watch in particular, the model that you're seeing right now in Canada after tax is $3,651. And is it worth it? I'm obviously gonna say no, because I probably wouldn't wanna wear this every single day as a smart connected watch, especially if there's many other options out there. But for those who are willing to spend the money or are LV fans, I also don't think you're really gonna be disappointed. I mean, with the earbuds, it was a little bit of a different story because it was a rebranded product that you could also just buy for under $300. But in this case, this is a product that LV has put together that is very good in terms of quality. It's got the nice design touches, the characteristic craftsmanship that you do expect, the presentation, and also does have some of their materials in terms of the watch bands, which you can pick between their whole different range of different colors and designs. I think if you have the money and are willing to spend it, this is a smartwatch that has the design aspect and the brand name, but also the latest and greatest tech with 1 gig of RAM and 8 gigs of storage paired with the Snapdragon 3100 internal processor. But in this video, I didn't want to just come out and show you a product that 99% of you are probably not going to buy, but I wanted to show you a watch that I think is actually good and is a good value for its price of under $200. So, and I think this watch has kind of the combination of value as well as performance and build quality. This right here is a TicWatch Pro, and I'm not paid by them to say anything. I actually went out and purchased this myself. And as you guys can see, it is around the same size in terms of the display as the LV watch, but a little bit larger overall. And the thickness is actually exactly the same at 12.6 millimeters. This watch actually has a slightly larger display at 1.39 inches and has a resolution of 400 by 400, and it is also an AMOLED. One thing that is unique though is the fact that it actually has a secondary display, which is an LCD that goes on top, which is why the AMOLED display looks a little bit recessed into the whole design. As a result, you're able to get up to 2 days of full battery life on this guy, and if you use just the LCD display to tell time like a digital watch, you can get up to 30 days, which is pretty impressive. This watch is IP68 rated, which means it's fine for 1.5 meters at up to 30 minutes, and even though if you decide to go deep sea diving, the LV watch can stand up to 30 meters, to be honest, if you have a watch at that price, you're probably gonna take it off in most cases if you're going underwater. Of course, because it is an Android Wear OS watch, it has thousands of watch faces and you have access to the entire Android Wear store similar to what you find on the LV watch. And in terms of specs, it has Snapdragon's previous generation 2100 Wear processor paired with 4 GB of storage and 512 MB of RAM. For the most part, everyday tasks are still able to handle very well on the previous generation processor, and when you're just changing music or doing some active apps like Google Fit and tracking your steps and workouts, then for the most part you should be okay, but the new processor is obviously a little bit more efficient, but does also kind of future-proof the watch for the next few years. I think the hardware is overall very solid as well. It's got the metal back and the bezel is made out of metal as well. And the straps can be changed to what you like, but this right here is a leather one and the inside is lined with silicone, which makes it a little bit less irritating on the skin. In terms of weight, this one is also not too bad. And I think paired with the flexibility with different features and the different modes and the displays that you can pick, at under $200, this is a very, very good option. Unless you are really into Louis Vuitton, have the money to spend, or insist on having a newer generation processor, which many other watches are going to have as well this year. But I just thought it'd be really cool to compare some watches that are very different in terms of price point, but similar in a lot of ways. They both run on Wear OS and work on both Android and iOS. And I was just also very curious of what the LV Tambor Horizon watch was able to offer, having never seen it in person before. I think when it comes to the general wearable industry, TicWatch is doing a very good job in offering value options that are and the features that they're able to give consumers, but at the same time, for a tech-related product, I think LV has also been doing a pretty decent job in terms of their earbuds as well as their watch, but it does come at an extreme cost for a company that is known for brand name. Considering the views of the first episode though, I think people are definitely curious as to what these designer companies are doing with modern day tech products. As always, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you drop a like and a huge apology for my sick voice that you had to listen through in this entire video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.